Let us now discuss Article 15, Alternative Circumstances. Pag sinabing alternative circumstances, pwede siyang mitigating circumstance, pwede din siyang aggravating circumstance. So the basis for the so-called alternative circumstance ay relationship, intoxication, degree of instruction, and education. So our memory aid is RIDE. So let us first discuss relationship. So relationship under alternative circumstances refers to sad bruises. So anong ibig sabihin ng sad bruises? That refers to the spouse for letter S, A, ascendant, D, descendant, and bro, that is brother, legitimate, natural, or adopted, and then S for sister, and letter A and S is affinity in the same degree. So relative by affinity in the same degree. Ang ibig sabihin ng relative by affinity in the same degree, kasing level siya sa brother at saka sister. And ang ibig sabihin ng affinity ay by marriage. So anong kasing level ng brother at saka sister by marriage? That refers to brother-in-law or sister-in-law. In this instance, relationship may either be mitigating or aggravating if the offender and the offended party belongs to the so-called relative under sad bruises. But there are other relatives, although not included in sad bruises, which are considered by the Supreme Court as either mitigating or aggravating. So these are the following: stepfather or stepmother to the stepson or stepdaughter. And the other one, adopted parent to the adopted child. So let us now discuss certain crimes under relationship, whether mitigating or aggravating. Let us start with crimes against property. So in crimes against property, it is said to be mitigating in the following. Our memory aid is RUFA. So that letter R stands for robbery, U, usurpation, F, fraudulent insolvency, and A, for arson. In crimes against property, relationship is exempting circumstance in the crimes of them. So anong ibig sabihin ng them? That is letter T, theft, E for estafa, and M, malicious mischief, if the offender and the offended party live together under the same roof. So ibig sabihin dito sa malicious mischief, kahit na ang offender at saka offended party ay nabilong sa tinatawag natin na sad bruises, pero hindi sila naninirahan sa iisang bubong, then there is no exempting or absolutory cause in malicious mischief. So, balikan lang natin konti ang concept natin sa exempting circumstance. Ang effect niya dito, walang criminal pero merong civil liability. In crimes against persons, it is said to be aggravating circumstance. So, the offended party is relative of higher degree than the offender. So, magiging aggravating circumstance siya kasi ang biktima ay higher degree. Halimbawa, ang parent versus child. So, ang offender ay ang anak, ang offended party is a parent. That is considered as aggravating circumstance. The offender and the offended party are relatives of the same level. So, ano yung relative of the same level dito? Halimbawa, brother versus sister. Or di kaya, brother-in-law versus brother-in-law. Or sister-in-law versus sister-in-law, or brother-in-law at saka sister-in-law. So they are of the same level. So that is considered as aggravating circumstance. In serious physical injuries, it is said to be aggravating circumstance even if the offended party is a descendant of the offender. So kahit na ang offended party ay mababa ang degree sa kanyang pagiging relative compared to the offender, basta serious physical injuries aggravating circumstance yan. As to the parent against his child, whether legitimate or illegitimate, so that is aggravating circumstance. So in less serious physical injuries or slight physical injuries, mitigating circumstance yeah, if the offended party is a relative of lower degree. It is aggravating circumstance if the offended party is relative of higher degree. Let us continue with some more discussion. In homicide or murder, aggravating circumstance ang relationship regardless of degree. So, kung pinatay ang relative, homicide or murder, except lang yung relative na pasok sa parricide. Parricide ang kaso doon. Pero dito, kung labas sa considered under the law para magiging parricide ang kaso, ang crime may either be homicide or murder. Aggravating circumstance, regardless of the degree of relationship between the offender and the offended party. In the crime of rape, aggravating circumstance, if the one committing the crime is the stepfather raping his stepdaughter, or the father raping his own daughter. How is relationship be appreciated in crimes against chastity? Sa lahat ng situation, no, ang acts of lasciviousness aggravating siya. So kahit na ang offender ay lower degree or higher degree kumpara sa offended party, aggravating circumstance siya. In the case of parricide, adultery, and concubinage, hindi siya makonsider na mitigating circumstance o aggravating circumstance. So, tandaan natin itong mga krimen na ito, parricide, adultery, at saka concubinage. So, ang pagiging relationship ay essential in the commission of these crimes. So, hindi na ma-appreciate whether it is mitigating or aggravating circumstance. So, punta na natin ang intoxication. So, kailan natin masabi na ang intoxication ay mitigating or aggravating? Kita natin dito sa table. So, it is said to be mitigating if it is not habitual. So, the opposite to that is habitual, that is aggravating. Another, it is not subsequent to the plan to commit the felony. Ang ibig sabihin nito, ang paglasing ay hindi ginamit na para mabigyan ng tinatawag na confidence ang tao bago isagawa ang krimen. Kasi alam natin, may mga tao na umiinom muna bago magkalakas loob na gawin ang isang bagay. Kaya, kahit na hindi si habitual, pero ang pag-inom niya ay pang palakas loob, then that is what we call as aggravating. Pero pag hindi to siya sinadya, hindi to siya plinano na maglasing muna bago gawin ang krimen, then that is mitigating. Pag intentional siya, then that is aggravating. Let us now go to instruction or education. What is the meaning of instruction or education? It is not only applicable or referring to literacy, but more to the level of intelligence. So, hindi lang patungkol ito sa pag-aaral, no? Formal na pag-aaral. Kundi, kung ano talaga ang level of intelligence ng tao. Kasi may mga taong hindi nga nakapag-aral, pero mataas ang kanilang intelligence. So, hindi to siya patungkol lang sa pinag-aralan, kundi sa intelligence talaga ng tao. So, lack of sufficient intelligence and knowledge of full significance of one's act. So, kulang sa talino or knowledge para maintindihan ang kanyang ginawa. So, the low and high degree of instruction and education may be considered as mitigating circumstance in general. High degree of instruction and education is considered as aggravating circumstance if the offender took advantage of his learning in committing crime. So for example, ang abogado, siya ang gumawa ng estafa, then that is aggravating circumstance kasi he has higher learning. Ginamit niya ang high degree of instruction and education. Let us now go to the rule on the degree of instruction and education. General rule, lack of sufficient education, that is mitigating circumstance. Exceptions, crimes against property, arson, estafa, theft, bribery. Crimes against chastity, treason, murder, and rape.